Hey, what's up, guys? Finally, with Phantom Rage coming out, we have our new Penguin Brave. I like the original name, Penguin Heroes. Penguin Brave is good too. This is a gorgeous artwork. Unfortunately, it's only a common, but still, this is a really cool card for Penguins. It's usually when they cast new support like this to like a random like not archetype, they just like it'll just have like some random effect. But this actually helps the deck. And it's good, but it's a Penguin card. But, you know, we try our best with what we got. So we're going to start off with the main deck. Actually, I'll read off what Penguin Brave does real quick. So when he protects the set monsters. So, you know, they're penguins. They all flip. So they're all protected while they're set. And when he's synchro summoned, he sets a penguin. Any penguin, no restriction, sets a penguin from the deck. And then when your opponent activates a monster effect, quick effect, you can target one set, and I think it's a set penguin, and then you can flip it face up, and of course, since they're flip monsters, the effect activates. So you can, you know, activate something like a penguin soldier on their turn whenever you want, or like, you know, chaining it to a monster effect, and you bounce two monsters to the hand when you want, not having to wait for the battle phase and whatnot. You know, you have to wait for a monster effect, but what Yu-Gi-Oh card isn't gonna have a monster effect nowadays. So yeah, really cool card, like great disruption, especially when you combo in the deck. So to get it started, we have three Penguin Soldiers starter deck super rares, absolute goat. Like people are gonna, you know, they're gonna, you know, blind game one, you're gonna set this and set maybe like a bluff spell or a trap. And then they won't know what's going on. They're going to attack into this. You're going to bounce two cards to their hand. It's going to be like 2006 all over again. It's going to be great. Next, we have two Puny Penguins. Puny Penguins are a really interesting card. It's just really slow. So when this card is flipped face up and then leaves the field, you can summon a penguin from the graveyard or set a penguin from the graveyard, excluding itself, of course. And this is just sent from the field, so you can flip it, link it away, and then get another monster back, which is a really cool and interesting effect when you really consider that, you know, you can reset, like, Penguin Soldier, Nightmare Penguin. We play one Penguin Torpedo. I think he's really bad, but, you know, it's just Penguin name, it is a niche effect. It sounds like it might be useful one day. It's 550, and he attacks directly, better than Meliseek, confirmed. But it'll come up one day, but it still hasn't come up in hours of playtesting. Two Glacial Penguins, Glacial Beast Penguins. This is the highest rarity penguin card. For what reason, I don't know, but this is a level 3 tuner. So this is what we're going to be using to go into our Penguin Brave, because it's level 6. So him and any other level 3. But he's really good. When he's destroyed by battle a card effect, you can bounce a card. When he's special summoned, you bounce I think they both bounce monsters, I'm sorry. But yeah, he can bounce monsters on some random occasions. But what you are mainly going to go into Penguin Brave with the other card is No Penguin. This card maybe want to build penguins. This is like actually an extremely good card. What he does is when a penguin effect activates, this card in the graveyard is mandatory chain link to automatically happens, so we automatically chain blocks to special summon itself to the field. And then when a penguin card would return a card from the field to back to the hand, it's banished instead. So instead of, you know, being like, oh, you know, I don't want to give them all these resources back, they're just going to do it to me again next turn, No Penguin just outright banishes it. So when you think about it in terms of Penguin Soldier, you're actually banishing two monsters instead of just returning two monsters to the hand, which is like pretty crazy when you think about it. Next, we have three Nightmare Penguins. Usually, I wouldn't play three of this one, but he's a level 4, and we run Ties of the Brethren. So, you know, for the statue and whatnot. And he gives a little attack boost. But he's interesting because he doesn't just bounce a monster. He bounces actually any card. Like, you know, set spell or trap or field spell or whatnot. So, and of course, No Penguin still works. It's Penguin. So you can banish any spell or trap or field spell, which is interesting. And then the apps, another actually really good card, Great Emperor Penguin. So you, So you can tribute this card and summon any two penguins from the deck. And this card is like, has so much potential. It's just level 5 with so little attack, but too much attack. It's hard to make it work with a lot of things just because of how weird it is. But yeah, this card, you tribute it, you summon back one of, from the deck, you summon a note penguin and a glacial penguin. And then that's like automatically, you have your penguin brave right there. And then you set up your penguin brave all over again. You can also summon two penguin soldiers. And the two penguin soldiers is two level 2 aquas. So that's a, what's his name? Totally awesome. And you can summon two note penguins. Oh, getting into focus. You can summon two note penguins. Because it's a level 3 aqua, if you have a legendary ocean, their levels go down by 1. So then they're two level 2 aquas. And you can summon, Totally Awesome from them too, if you have a legendary ocean on the field. And if you have a legendary ocean on the field, you can actually just normal summon him. There's things like water hazard to special summon something and then tribute it. There's a few ways to get him out. But seeing him as soon as possible is like the main thing. I don't know waters enough to search him. That's the only thing. If you guys know any like water support, anything I should be looking into, like let me know ASAP. Warrior of Atlantis is actually a gorgeous looking ultimate rare. But you can discard this card and search for a legendary ocean. He's also a level 4. And he discarding himself like sets up for Aqua Spirit. So you can discard him, search for Aqua Spirit. Search for a legendary ocean. Special Aqua Spirit and then tribute, summon Great Emperor Penguin. And then do all your combos and put a legendary ocean at the end of it. Speaking of our two Aqua Spirits. I run two of them. There's not really much to say. It's just like, it just summons itself and it's level 4. It's like, it puts itself on the field. It's, so I can tie to the Brethren with it or link it off or like Miss Starboy or something. Next we have three, Torrents. This is like one of the main defenses. So what you're really trying to do is you're trying to see this. So you're trying to like lock them out of like anything, because like, unless they're playing Mermails, it's over for them. If they are playing Mermails, it was over for you before the game was started. But you know, you see, you have this, and then you have like the penguins just like bouncing whatever they're like normal summoning, so they're kind of stuck in like a loop. So that's like the best thing. That's like one of the best things you can do that I've found so far. We have three. True King Barristros. This is to... Mainly he, like, puts... He's a special summon, and he puts Note Penguin, and... he puts other penguins in Graveyard. Oh, he puts Penguin Soldier in Graveyard. I used to run a Prediction Princess, so this worked out perfectly, because it's a level 9. Prediction Princess is a level 9. This puts Penguin Soldier and Note Penguin in the Graveyard, which is, Note Penguin just wants to be in the Graveyard. Penguin Soldier is good for, Prediction Princess, because it's a flip monster, so you can summon it back. I don't want Prediction Princess in this build, but I still love True King Barristros because it's just big. It banishes spells and traps, you know. He just does so much. It's just like, I can't imagine the deck without him. He just does like quite a bit. Moving on to our spells, we have three Ties of the Brethren. This is for our level 4s, so we can summon out the statue. And so you're going to summon out the statue and the Nightmare Penguin just so you boost his attack by a little bit, just to hope for the best. But, and you can do that at the end. Like, you can summon, like, what's it called? You can summon, like, Penguin Heroes and stuff like, or Penguin Brave, and then set, or whatever. And then summon, like, Aqua Spirit, and then use Aqua Spirit for Ties of the Brethren. It's not the strongest board, but it's a pretty tough board to get over. We have Terraforming and Set Rotation. Terraforming to search out the Legendary Ocean or the Dragonic Diagram. And Set Rotation is like... it's really good right now because of... there's a lot of Invoked players in the meta. And if you like Set Rotation and give them like a Legendary Ocean, they have absolutely no use for it. So they just have a legendary ocean, and then they can't, like... So if you just don't use your field spell, then they can't, like, use Meltdown, and they can't... If that's their only way of searching Alistair, then they can't do it. It's actually, like, pretty funny, because then it's, like... They have to suffer the Penguin Wrath, and then they can't use their field spell. Next, we have our three legendary oceans. This card is, like, 50 prints and, like, common. Like, there's just, like, nothing better we can do. This is, like, the highest, like, low-rarity deck I've ever had. But, a legendary ocean, it's a really good card. It, like, lowers all water's levels by one. In the hand and field for both players. So, like, if your opponent is running some waters, like, it really could mess them up. I don't really know for certain what it does against Mermails and Marincess, but it really could mess them up if they have a bunch of, like, rank 7s and then they, like, all their monsters are level 6 now. So, like, that sounds like an interesting thing. But mainly, it's the lowering Emperor Penguin by 1, which was really cool. But now that we have Penguin Brave, it's, like, really lame because you can't use this and Emperor Penguin to go into Penguin Brave because it just lowers levels by too much because it asks for too much now. Still really good, though. And then we have the 1 Dragonic Diagram. This is just a... Sometimes you, like, use it to destroy, like a random water for Aqua Spirit or something, or put no Penguin in Graveyard. Because getting no Penguin in Graveyard isn't the easiest thing to do, unless you have, you know, Great Emperor Penguin. And then sometimes you won't even summon the Barbastros. You just, like, you just get the thing in Graveyard. Next, we have 3 Water Hazards. This is a pretty cool card. If you control no monsters, you can special summon a level 4 lower water from your hand. A soft once per turn. So if they, like, get rid of it somehow, you can use another one and then use it again. But it's a really cool card. You can, like, special summon anything and then tribute it for Great Emperor Penguin and then start your life. And then lastly, for 3 traps, we have White Howling. This is a really interesting card. If your opponent has a spell in Graveyard, then and you control a water monster, then you can negate all their spells on their field for the whole turn. It's like a really weak of the Harpy's Feather Trap, but it's a really strong card. They essentially have only one spell they can use, because, I mean, they use their one spell and then it goes to grave, and then after that they have no more spells. And this isn't something you can, like, really see coming to stop that often that easily. So it's a really interesting card in that way. And like I said, locking someone out of spells for the turn, and yeah, the barrier statue and all that, it really stops someone. Moving on to the extra deck, we have 2 Penguin Braves, the absolute greatest. So the best combo is, you know, you get Great Emperor Penguin on the field, and then you tribute it, and you summon the Note Penguin and the Glacial Penguin, and then you summon this, and then you set the Penguin Soldier. And then when you activate this effect to set the monster, Note Penguin automatically summons itself from the graveyard. So then they can't even ash this, because Note Penguin's gonna chain link 2 mandatory. So it's mad lit. They can't ash it, they can't ogre it. They can, like, veil or impermanence it, but are you really gonna impermanence, like, a Penguin Synchro monster? Like, how hard do you have to go? Like, come on. You gotta, like, let it go through, you gotta see what they're gonna do. But yeah, and then you can just bounce whatever during their turn. It ends up being 2 banishes. Absolutely. It's a pretty sick combo. It's like, it'll really catch someone off guard. For XYZs, we have Utopia and Utopia the Lightning. We have quite a few level 4s. And then, like, Utopia the Lightning is just a quick way to get rid of Dragoon and stuff like that. And they're just some really big monsters. You can just attack over it. This is pretty simple. There's not much to say about that. for our other 2 rank 4s, Abyss Dweller and Bahamut Shark. Bahamut Shark's just another way to go into Toad. And then Abyss Dweller actually, you know, you can lock someone out, and it actually gains, like, additional attack because you use a water monster. You know, we have all waters in the deck. So he's actually kind of cool like that. So you can put him in attack mode, you can trick your opponent a little bit, and they're going to attack into it, they're not going to know that effect, and then hopefully they'll lose it. We have 1 rank 3, because we have quite a bit of rank 3s, sorry. The Phantom Knights of Breaksword. I just thought it was an interesting card, destroying, you know, a card you control, a card your opponent controls. It just seems like fun. I didn't really know. I searched up rank threes, and this is like the only one I was familiar with. And I was like, yeah, I'll just go with it. But it just seems like a cool card, and it looks really nice too. Phantom Knights, maybe? No. Totally awesome. And Cat Shark, our last two XYZs, and they are rank twos. You can replace this with a second totally awesome. I wanted to try him out. I never really got to use him yet, but he looks really like adorable. Him and Toad are like best friends or something. They're like dumb and cute. I don't know what they are. But yeah, Toad's just really good. I don't think I really need to explain it. You know, you have a negate on board. But Cat Shark is he like helps you like I think he's like attacks directly or something. I don't fully remember it, but I just remember him being good. But yeah, you can run two Toads. I don't think the Toad effect to add a water monster from grade is necessary. So I just, you know, I just add the same Toad back. So it doesn't seem like that much of an issue. And for our Lynx, we have a card that fell on the floor. We have Relinquished Anima and Link Rebo. This is mainly for Puny Penguin because, you know, like I said, it's slow. But if you get it off, you flip the Puny Penguin, you summon a monster. You flip it and you link it away for like Anima. And you take one of their monsters, you summon a monster. And then you can just, you have like two monsters, and you took away one of their monsters, and you just keep going. Like Link climbing and stuff. For our Link 2s, we have Miss Starboy, Nightmare Phoenix, and Nightmare Cerberus. These are just some simple Link 2s, you know. Get rid of a special summon monster, get rid of a Speller Trap, and just boost all our waters. We have all waters, we have no fires. It's never going to hurt us. It's only going to help us. And he has like a similar effect to Toad. But when he's destroyed by battle card effect, you can add a water back from your graveyard to your hand, which is like, it's not like the most useful effect, but you know, you might add something that you really need. For our last, Boar Sword Dragon. I actually have gotten into him before. Don't even like think that he's like impossible to go into. He actually is. But it's not the most consistent thing, but it actually needs Puny Penguin. But it's like no one's going to expect you to summon a Boar Sword and Penguins. And they're going to see Boar Sword, and they're going to be like, oh, it's like what am I going to do? But yeah, that's our Penguin deck profile. Like I said, I hope you guys help me out in the comments. Like, I don't know too much about the deck. I mean, I don't know too much about Waters in general, but I really want to learn more so that I can improve the deck. I've seen a build with our friend Glacial Penguin, where they just kept summoning this from the graveyard and stuff like that, and just kept bouncing a card during their opponent's turn. Someone actually used it against me. It was pretty fun to play against. But yeah, let me know, guys. You know, comments are appreciated, and thanks for watching.